Just a few days ago, I had the pleasure of visiting the Chatham Islands. It took a couple of hours before the plane was able to leave Wellington because of very, very strong crosswinds on the island, but we finally got away and landed safely an hour and a half later. Chatham Islands are a great community of people. There's just under 650 people there, and there's an extraordinary variety of wildlife. Had a chance to meet a lot of people in the community, including members of the Chatham Islands Council and the Chatham Islands Trust, and also played the parliamentary rugby team, of which I'm a member, played a spirited game against the Chatham Islands local team, which sadly we lost 17-15. But some of the things that came up there were interesting, and in the time that I've been back, myself and colleagues have raised certain issues with ministers as a result of the discussions we had with the islanders. I personally have got in touch with TV1, TV3 and Sky in a bid to try and get the Chatham Islands mentioned on the weather map and also the weather forecast for the islands. They are part of New Zealand, and that was one of the things that they said would mean a lot to them, to see themselves on the weather map. So we'll see if we can make a little bit of progress on that. Had a chat to the Minister, Tony Ryle, to ease up the transfer for patients who have to go to the mainland for treatment, allow them to be treated in Christchurch and possibly Wellington as well, rather than have to go to Napier where they need to go at this stage to get their treatment. So there's a few other things that the local community have appraised me of would be good for them, and myself and other members of the group taking those up with appropriate ministers. Some very good news for the Chatham Islands today. Jerry Brownlee announced the sum of something over $2 million for the Chatham Islands Marine Energy Limited to put in some two 110 kilowatt Wells turbines to actually create energy from wave action on that very stormy Chatham Island coast. So that would go a long way towards providing energy for the Chatham Islands and obviate the need to import expensive diesel fuel. So there's a lot of things happening in the Chathams. It's a great place. I urge you all to go and visit it, and we're certainly trying to do our bit to make life easier for those folk who have the pleasure of living there. Thanks.